How's it, everybody? My name is Jonathan, and I'm playing Tony in the Fugard Theatre's production of West Side Story. And what happened today is they gave me a camera, and they gave me free rein, which they might regret. And they said, let's get a video diary going. So over the next few video posts and that, we're going to be showing you what it's like to put on a musical from the actor's point of view. And that started today with the first day at school, basically meeting everybody and getting to know, you know, your other halves. And in my particular case, I don't have one half, I have another two halves. My Maria is played by Linnell Kennard, who you might recognize from Orpheus and Showboat. And the Maria understudy, alternate, is Philippa van Eck, all the way, well, back from London for a while for us to grace our stages. And they are worse looking Marias, I can tell you that. And they're nice people, which always helps. And you want to talk about jumping straight in the deep end? We went straight into One Hand, One Heart today, which, for those of you that don't know West Side Story, it's where Tony and Maria pretend to get married. And, you know, I like to consider myself a reasonably considerate leading man. And I shaved the night before, because I suspected we might start kissing. And we went straight into it, and it was full-on kissing this time. That's as much as I'll tell you about that scene. And I don't know, I must have super stubble or something, because I looked up at one point, Linnell had a little red beard on, and she was like, no, it's fine, it's a fun way to get it, the stubble. I'm going to get in trouble for that. And then I got to do it with Philippa, who ended up with exactly the same problem. And I mean, you know, there are worse ways to earn a paycheck of sorts. But the fun thing that we started finding today, I mean, I didn't see the dance stuff, which is going on. We're in 308, they're in 301. You know, the thing about West Side Story is you hear the music and you kind of know what's going on in the next room. But hopefully later in the week, I'll start getting to see more of that. I'll give you a sneak peek and all that. And at the moment, it's tough because Tony and Maria aren't part of the full show, you know, on a choreographic level. So we're in the other room kissing most of the time, and they are in the main rehearsal room dancing. But we've got a pretty good team with us. Matthew, our director, Louisa, our choreographer, Charles, who you might recognize as the MC from Cabaret, he's conducting on the show. And we got to sing through a lot of the music today. And our stage manager, Juanita, who I worked with years ago, and finally we're back working together, she just kept shaking her head saying, oh, this music. And it's easy to forget that this is one of the best scores of all the other musicals out there. So I will say, purely just from a musical point of view, if you haven't booked your tickets, book your tickets for the score alone. It's going to be a 30-piece orchestra at the Artscape. And we got to see a model of the set. I can't show you footage of that. But it is a big show. It is a big, big show. And from the initial sing-throughs today, it's going to be something really, really special. So if you haven't booked, I've been instructed, nay, I have been told to tell you that you should book your tickets as soon as you can through Computicket or the Fugard box office, and we'll see you at the theatre. But in the meantime, I will see you back here talking about the show and whatever fun stuff happens from here on in the Artscape Opera House rehearsal rooms. And I might even take my phone in and film some sneak peeks and show you what's going on behind the scenes. I make no apologies for any bad language that the cast uses, or for that matter, our creative team. So that's day one of rehearsal. Slow start, but a good one. And I'll catch you for day two coming soon. Cheers.